أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين صدق الله العظيم. This is verse 155 of Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2. And this is the verse that we've selected in the Ramadan planner for 16th of Ramadan Mubarak. And it's a very well-known verse. And usually we tend to hear this verse around the time of Muharram when we're talking about the Battle of Karbala. But the 16th of Ramadan Mubarak, the eve that's coming, this is the eve of Badr, the night before the day of Badr, an epic day in Islamic history. The Holy Quran mentions that incident that took place, the battle that took place between the believers and those who didn't believe in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. It was the first battle, and there's so many lessons that we can draw from it. But in the context of this verse, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, certainly we will test you with some of fear, walju, and hunger. Now in that, if we just reflect on that, the Battle of Badr is going about to take place, and there's a background to it. The time doesn't permit us to go into that, but there are around 313 companions with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they left Medina Munawwarah not to fight a battle, but with a different intention in mind. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, إِذْ يَعِدُكُمُ اللَّهِ إِذَا الطَّائِفَتَيْنِ, that it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He would grant victory to you over one of the two groups. So one group was a caravan that was going from Syria to Mecca, back to Mecca. And this was one group that the Muslims could intercept. And the other was the people from Mecca who were coming to attack the Muslims. The Muslims, 313 individuals without any support, without any arms at that time, because they hadn't left Mecca to fight, they hadn't left Medina to fight a battle. On the other side, the people from Mecca, they were coming fully armed to their teeth effectively, and they wanted to effectively remove Muslims from the face of the earth. This was their intention. And at that time, can you imagine how much fear they would have had in their hearts? It's natural to have that fear in hearts. But it was their unshakable trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They knew it was a test from Allah. Allah says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ, certainly we will test you with some of fear. So fear is natural in their hearts. But actually what they had was trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that helped them overcome that fear. And the night before, the eve of Badr, the Battle of Badr, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all night prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Narrations say that he was vigorously praying to Allah, raising his hands and crying his eyes out, calling on to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying that if this small group of people didn't achieve victory in the morning, then until the day of judgment, no one will be able to say your name, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the words that this is the everything, this is my asset that I have developed over a period of nearly 15 years, starting from the day when he declared his prophethood, for 15 after he brought all of them together. And then if they were to be wiped off the face of the earth, there'd be nothing left, no one to declare the unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the divine nature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the lesson that we learn from all of this, there, sometimes we face challenges in our lives. There's so many challenges in our lives, and we want to fix it. We just like pray to Allah very quickly and say, Ya Allah, just fix this problem. But here, what we learn from the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he can see that there's death facing his community tomorrow. And he all night he's praying, yet he knew that it was Allah's mission and Allah would grant them victory, because that's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised in the Holy Quran. But still showing the humility, showing that actually we are helpless without support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the key lesson that we learn from the eve of the battle of Badr on the 16th of Ramadan Mubarak, the night before the 17th, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed all night to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, we have so many issues in our lives, so many challenges. The one way to overcome all of those challenges is to turn to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with hope, with humility, with hope that actually it is only Allah that will be able to who will be able to help us in this dire moment of need. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends His support to us like He did on the day of Badr. Inshallah, tomorrow we will talk about this battle of Badr in a bit more detail.